All right, so before we get started, I just wanted to give a quick intro. StackRabbit is a Tetris AI I've been working really hard on the past few months, and it's gotten a lot of really cool achievements, but this game blew my mind, and I'm so excited to share it with all of you. So let's jump into it. As you can see, I've limited the AI to do only what is pretty reasonable within human limitations. So it can tap 13.5 times per second, and that's for moving the piece side to side. And it also has a pretty hefty 416 millisecond reaction time, which is well above the human reaction time of 250 milliseconds. But humans also have a little bit of extra time to think, so that's why there's a little bit more of a buffer. But this gameplay is very much doable for humans. 13.5 hertz is like a little bit fast, but it's much slower than the top players who are setting world records. And as you can see by the other achievements on screen, when you take away some of these limitations, it just goes absolutely crazy. So that's why I kind of keep its achievements in separate categories based on what it's capable of input-wise. As you can see, it's making some really cool placements, and in particular, the adjustments it does based on the next piece that's coming are what I think is really cool. So it'll set up like an overhang that just perfectly fits the next piece so that its resulting stack is a little bit better. And for those of you wondering how it works, it's essentially reading the board and then doing a move search up to three moves into the future. Some of that is based on the next piece, if it's seen it yet. Otherwise, it looks at like all the different possible futures based on all the possible pieces it can get. And of course, it has to do some pruning, so it'll only look at certain futures if it thinks that they're reasonable. If it's just completely terrible, then it's not worth wasting the computing power. And then I've put a lot of work into designing a function to evaluate how good a board is, based on a lot of different principles and research and statistical testing, based on how much everything is worth. And there's also another really cool component that was contributed by Fractal, another Tetris player, and that's a rating for how good all the different board surfaces are. Like, if you take away all the holes and how high it is and what level you're on, and just look at the shape of the top of the board, that can tell you a lot about how the pieces are going to fit together. And he ran a value iteration algorithm on that, and it gives really good ratings for the general feel of the board. And obviously there's a lot more that you need than just that, but it's still a major component, so credit to him for that. But as you can see, it's playing on level 18 right now, which is a relatively manageable speed. And so when you're on 18, what you're trying to do is completely maximize efficiency. You want to get all Tetrises and not waste any line clears, because you only have a limited number before you hit kill screen. Kill screen is level 29, where the speed drastically increases and you have to completely change your stacking because you really can't get pieces where you want them to go. And so in the past few years, humans have for the first time started really playing into kill screen by developing all these new stacking techniques. And I've worked really hard to let StackRabbit explore different ways to stack on the kill screen, and in particular look at how to build out and maintain the sides of the board, because those are the ones that are really, really hard to get pieces to. So it'll strategically use particular ones and keep particular shapes that will lead to a good left side in the future. And we'll see that more once we get there. But for now, it is taking its time and trying to play really efficiently. And it's doing adjustments when it can, and really just trying to keep a clean board that can accommodate any piece. For context, the human world record was set by Joseph Saelee last year, and that is 1.439 million. StackRabbit has already beaten that with human-like parameters. Some say the reaction time was a little bit fast at 250 milliseconds, but it's still quite impressive to get 1.4 million. And it's also gotten a couple 1.4 millions without any kill screen play, whereas humans have only once gotten 1.4, and it was a significant kill screen play. Alright, now it's getting up a little high, so it's going to want to stack it down, and then it gets the long bar, so that'll bring the stack down. Now it's in a much more reasonable state. I've talked a lot about the kill screen, but there's also another level speed up that's going to happen at 130 lines. So level 18 is a pretty comfortable pace, and then once you get to 19 and beyond, it's going to go up 50% faster, where it's definitely more uncomfortable. You can't get pieces all the way high on the left, so you really have to manage your stack size. And also with its reaction time, if you get high up on 19, you pretty much have to place the piece with no knowledge of what's coming next. You just have to kind of create a generally accommodating board and that works with as many pieces as possible. As it's coming into 130 lines in level 19, it's already at past 600,000 points, which is generally a target for humans trying to get a good score. You want 600 plus, maybe 650, or even a little bit past that for a really, really good game. But it's definitely unusual to get 650 or more transition. So it hops into 19 with a 675, which is quite a good pace. It's not the best it's ever gotten. When it goes fully all out and really tries to not burn at the expense of sometimes dying, it's actually gotten a perfect transition, so no burns into transition. It's also gotten one with one burn, which is technically more points into level 19, but depends how you want to define it. But right now it's playing with like medium aggressive parameters, so it wants to score Tetrises and it's willing to take some risk, but it's not going all out. It's taking some burns when it needs to. And sometimes it does really cool ones like that. That stuff is so cool. And that last second adjustment to perfectly let the J piece fit in. I think that was an L actually. But now it is completely stabilized and it gets the long bar. There's a Tetris. It's got a great stack. And it's actually interesting. It hasn't gotten that many long bars this game. Typically, when you'll see people get really, really good games, they'll get tons and tons of long bars. They always have one ready to score when they need. But it's making do with not a particularly high amount. It also has 80 S pieces, which is generally viewed as the worst piece in the game, but it is managing just fine. Now we can see that it's approaching a million points, which is what was long called the max out, because an unmodified version of the game just shows 999999, but people got so good that they uncapped the score and play well beyond max out. You heard the human world record is 1.4 million, well past a million. The bot's world record, when it has no restrictions at all, it's gotten 47 million by playing forever on kill screen. And also stacking for Tetrises on kill screen, not just lining out. And there we go, it has crossed a million. It is at A02, which in hexadecimal refers to 1,000,002. Another one now, 1,030,000, and we'll see it creep up A, B, C, D. If you translate the world record into hexadecimal, the world record is E39. And StackRabbit's PB so far, with human-like parameters, is E65. So those will be the targets to beat. Interestingly, as I mentioned, it's not going completely aggro right now. So it's not going to go into kill screen with an insane score. It's still very, very good, but it's not mind-blowing. What really sets this game apart is its kill screen play, which is unlike anything we've ever seen. Of course, some of you may be aware of the new revolution that's happening where people are learning to press buttons really, really, really fast, and that almost makes kill screen stacking trivial because you actually can get pieces where you want them to go. But for now, StackRabbit is trying to optimize the traditional way of playing where you tap the pieces manually. There we go, it's gonna go into kill screen with C79 or 1.279. And now it is struggling. It needs very particular pieces to be able to get to the left. A square can make it, L's can make it, and J's can make it, but pretty much everything else is not gonna get there. Anytime you wanna get something vertically, it's probably not gonna get there. You really have to preemptively build it out and be really strategic about what shapes you put on the left so that in the future when you put pieces there it won't ruin it. It won't ruin the shape. So it makes that really, really strange-looking L dependency, but that's one of the only pieces that can get all the way there. So sometimes you do have to make just those shapes, and then when you do get the L, you end up with a great left side. And so it's doing some counterintuitive stuff, but it's really working out, and it's getting the pieces it needs. Sometimes kill screen does come down to RNG. When only a few pieces can fill out to the side, you just need to get them sometimes. And it's getting up a little bit high, but it is just barely holding on, and it gets the square. And now when it's an L and another square, now its left side is looking good. And on the right side, there's also a couple particular pieces that are really good at getting to the right. You'll see that tower of Z pieces. No other piece can get that high, but it knows that, and it knows to build out with the one piece that it can. And now it's starting to build up for a Tetris, which is worth a ton of points, but is extremely risky, and it's gonna go for it. It's ready for the Tetris. If it doesn't get a long bar, it's immediately dead, but it finally gets it, and now it just gets the right combination of pieces to perfectly clean down, and there we go. The only time that it can actually get a long bar vertically to the left is when it's all the way cleared down to the bottom. And it just barely slides one over, and now it is actually stabilized from that crazy high stack before the Tetris. It somehow managed to stabilize, which is absolutely insane. And look at the score. E70. It has passed both the human world record and its PB. And it's still going. It has its side built out. There's no immediate end in sight. It's just barely slipped some pieces over. That square is as high as it can possibly get it. But it knows its own limits, and it calculates out what the result of the inputs will be, so it doesn't go for anything it doesn't know it can make. And it is, it's playing with fire, but it just barely gets the 1.5. And now it's trying to stack down, but the T can only get there in that weird orientation. It doesn't go the other way. And so the left side is completely screwed, and it is just gonna fight for its life on top, flinging pieces left and right, just trying to scrape together a couple more lines to pad its score just a little bit further. But an F score has never gotten even close by a human, and it is the first human realistic AI to do it too. So this game is monumental on so many levels. And there you'll see F47 is the final score, which is just completely insane. 268,000 points in the kill screen with not a particularly fast tapping speed. The humans that have gotten far into kill screen can typically tap 15, 16, 17 hertz. For a 13.5 hertz AI to get this far is really cool. There are also other people doing AI, and StackRabbit has gotten a lot of records right now, but who knows what's going to happen. So stay tuned to the community. There's going to be some bot competitions. StackRabbit is going to continue to get better. It's a great time for Tetris AI, so stay tuned, there's lots more to come.